What's good, YouTube? It's Jay here, and we're back with Thrawn's Revenge. They actually just updated this mod today to the 2.3.3 version, and we're gonna be playing it because why not? So to get started with today's Let's Play, for one, I know it's been a while since I uploaded Empire War content, so I'm sorry about that. I've just been having an extremely fun amount of time recording and streaming and recording or streaming. That's what I'm trying to say. And it's just been so fun, honestly. Today, we're gonna do something different. I've never done a playthrough on this. We're gonna go with Empire of Han. We're gonna be doing at least two or three Imperial playthroughs in addition to a New Republic playthrough. Synonymously, maybe. Synonymously, you're not. Maybe not. That's not really a word, but we'll go with it. So we're gonna go with the Empire of the Han. We're on Art of War. And we're on my new gaming rig. The new, brand new 16 gigabyte God machine that I built recently. I don't remember if we get an opening crawl. I think we do. Or not. Actually, let's see. Eerie 30 is conquered Yagdol, the throne's Greek commander. Okay. Whoa, I just got some crazy static out of nowhere. So yeah, I did a preview video on this stuff. I don't think too much of this has changed. It doesn't look like it anyway. Here's some scheduling stuff. Heroes and Tears, yada yada. If you haven't seen this already, just go watch my Thrawn's Revenge review and preview video. I'll link it in the description below. But it's pretty straightforward stuff. But we're just not going to go over it right now because that'd be like 20 minutes of the video already. So yeah, we're playing as the Empire of the Han on Essence of War. And there is... Or Art of War? Essence of War, I think it is. Essence of War? We got a lot going on. This is our little small like corner of the galaxy. The rest of the galaxy is pretty full. I honestly don't think the New Republic's going to survive because I did a little bit of some practice like play with them before. And God, if they do, it's just because the AI. That's all I can say. It's so hard to play as New Republic now compared to before because we start off relatively close to them already. Like they're really in like some horrible spots. Honestly, like Generis is literally between like up in like three different factions of the Empire almost. I'm sorry, I'm just keeping some weird static. My head's up, but yeah. There's a lot to... The Republic's gonna struggle, man. Because they've only got these two worlds out here. They've got to fight off, like, three different Imperial factions that'll all come for the neck, like, through this region. It's rough. They're in a bad spot. I feel for them 100%, I promise. But we're in our little nestle corner of the galaxy. Don't know what the heck is this. Alright, let's take a look at our ships. Because I don't know a single ship unit. Let's see, what do we have? Got the Azdroni. Alright, so this is our Corvette. I'll leave this right here so you can read the description of that. The Naruto, I guess. It's a heavily armed frigate. Alright, so this is our heavy frigate. I remember reading this before. It's the glut, even though there's okay. This is the Prosvoli. I know this is a remake of the Dreadnought Cruiser. Yeah, this is just basically a remake of the Dreadnought Cruiser. And this is our actual, like, Dreadnought, like, Star Destroyer as well. This is That's it keeps buzzing, it's freaking me out. He commands an Ascendancy class Star Destroyer, Admiral or Commander Stint. We've got Admiral Arulani, a former city of Tatooine who was transferred. Okay. And Nirwan is the headquarters of our little empire back here. Now I know we've got a couple of different Imperials. We've got Vols Parak, he commands Victory. He commands the Star Destroyer and Monitor. Thrawn actually commands the Grey Wolf, another Star Destroyer. So, I mean, we're in a good position. We can literally just push out to three different locations and have all of our borders kind of defendable. I mean, the New Republic is literally not going to push us at all. They're in a bad spot where if you move a ship from even one of their planets, it's going to be heavily under defended. New Republic is really like playing on hard modes. I can't wait to play with them. And then we got Bakura over here, which is not a threat at all. Moving out. Literally, like, it's not a threat at Heading all. Out. It's like, it's not even a real planet. It's on just some one of those, like, stand-in unit type things, however you want to say that Looking correctly. The Corporate Sector 3 has conquered DeServo. Servo. Oh, alright. Alright, so this is where we're gonna get all of our updates and stuff there now. That's kind of interesting. Mildly annoying already. Well, no, I wouldn't say, I guess it's not really annoying. Alright, what can we build actually? This is an interdictor. Okay. We can build more ships here. We've got the Chaff Destroyer. We've got the... This is our carrier. I think we'll build more, a couple of these. More Asdronis. More of the Narutos. Naruto. I'm gonna just call it the Uzumaki class. What we got here? The Vigilance Gunship. Fast Daily Vigilance. Okay, so it's cheap. We'll build like five of them. Cheap but dependable. Constructing. Just like American plastic engineering. Cheap but dependable. The Psyka Fleet Systems, 30% discount. So this is our capital shipyard planet, technically. We've got a couple of... What in the hell is this? There's the Ascendancy Class Star Destroyer, and there's the Syndicate Destroyer. Originally designed to engage, so this is the Peltas class Star Destroyer. Originally designed to engage Sissy Ruby ships from a distance before they could deploy their swarm fighters. Peltas is essentially a giant large mega massive cannon. Oh yeah, so all the Star Destroyers and four units in there in this mod. And for the record, I see now they have like a description of the complements, weapons, etc. That's actually pretty neat. I don't know how loud the music is, unfortunately, because I changed a lot of settings and stuff around. But I do know for a fact that and if it isn't too loud, nobody really cares. But, they all run on things called Mega Masers, which are just their version of lasers. Let's see. Okay. So it's not too deadly individualistically. From a distance it is, rather. But, otherwise, it's just a pretty straightforward Star Destroyer. It's just a big gun. It's literally a crate destroyer. That's all it is. So I'm not... Okay, that's not too bad. So we've got Bill Bringy. Excuse me. We've got Bill Bringy in our way over there. Maybe we'll push the Pentastar Alignment. Granted, they're one of my favorite Imperial factions. That or... Well, no, the Pentastar Alignment has a Superstar Destroyer basically right out of the gate, just like every other Imperial faction, I guess, also does. But I feel like capturing Bill Bringy arguably might be the better option. Notice we got a different ship here. We've got the fleet center, Aphthonia. Wait a minute, what? The Greater Madra has conquered Kessel. Toss Beaker. Wait, what in the hell is going on right now? There's so much happening. Because Toss Beacon's like in the core, isn't it? Oh, from there to there. And the Empire captured those guys capture Kessel. Maybe that's not what I'm understanding about New Republic strategy when I play as them. You have to just turtle. I don't know. Anyway, I'm getting distracted. These are actually kind of more annoying. Well, I wouldn't say annoying, but they're easy to get distracted by. Okay, well, whatever. We'll just try to avoid paying attention to them. We need to build up a standing military force. Unit canceled. I'm gonna delete those and recruiting soldiers. I think these are spies. Well, kind of. They're commandos. We can build a lot of tanks here. Against multiple targets. It's a heavy vehicle, so that's nice. We'll build a rapid fire tank. Unit in production. Go easy on these things. Just cancel most of them. Mortar units, which is actually significantly more cheaper than the Mobile Proton's Repeater Launcher. We'll move these forces up here. Grand Emerald, Danetta Pita has been killed. Everybody's dying already. And Zinj.
Reporting.
New Republic has conquered deep space. What the hell does that mean? I'm getting so distracted by the news feed up here. Okay, okay, okay. We're gonna pay attention. Deep space. Interesting. There's so much happening. Okay. The AI New Republic is gonna get so much more money than I would as an individual player, which kind of sucks, but you know. Okay, we're gonna drop you off here.
D2B over.
This news feed's okay. If it didn't have the alerts to it, we're just slowing the crowd. Rihanna. Alright, but everybody's just dying basically right now. We didn't even scout Bill Bring out. We just kind of went for it. Just YOLO swaggered our way up there. That's the name of my legacy in Star Wars: The Republic, the YOLO swagger. I was like 15 when I made it, okay? Okay. Don't judge me. Also, we should probably capture Korek, because I have no idea what's actually happening over there. But yeah, let's go to our first battle.
Enemy forces ahead.
I'm also using a different keyboard for now. So it's, if you hate the clicking, I'm sorry. Oh, they finally put engines. Last time I remember when I played as these guys. Okay, so we're gonna do that.
Of course.
Gonna call in all of our big ships. Two Star Destroyers, right? Three if you count this being a different version of it, technically. We're not gonna call that in, because I feel like that's more susceptible to death. Got a lot of ships here.
Reinforcements canceled.
Put some ass drones here, not that it's really gonna matter. They also have different voiceovers too.
We're seeing that now. What do you need, sir?
It only took out one of the engines, so we're gonna retreat it out of here. Should be retreating? There we go. See, hyperspace abilities. Oh, they changed the Dreadnought model. I haven't really kept up with this mod as much as I probably should have lately, but that is way nicer than the original one. No discredit to the original artist, obviously, but that is a very beautiful model. I also thought they changed these already, but maybe they didn't. Alright, well. I know they will eventually, probably. And here's our replica of the Dreadnought, pretty much. Alright, we're just gonna focus pretty much all our fire on this. Let's get all of our starfighters. So yeah, the Empire of the Hand has their own, like, imperialized, or high, like, they're chissified versions of Imperial ships. So that's why they all share some kind of similarity. Let's see if we can get all of our starfighters grouped up. Getting some weird little, like, phrase frames and stuff. It's a little weird. Let's see.
Yes, sir. Awaiting orders.
I forgot that these things are, like, half carrier and half guns. It's very interesting to see how I'm saying these. I'm gonna get them out of here, though. I think it's three Dreadnought cruisers. Interesting. I wonder why it keeps sticking like that.
Yeah.
It dropped off its complement. Actually, let me see something real quick. Shouldn't be sticking like that. It's kind of annoying. Ooh, V-Sync was enabled. Yikes. Okay, anyway. I might fix that now. Or not! I got a little careless with my ass dronies. Let's get the other two out of here. Let's see. So yeah, they're just stuck. They're dead. They're totally 100% dead. Let's take a look at this model. This thing looks really cool. You could see the Dreadnought in it. It almost looks identical to it. Also, switching off V-Sync fixed that issue. Hallelujah. Just remember, kids, if you do a fresh installation of Empire War, turn off V-Sync. I think. We actually didn't lose these, just when they jumped to hyperspace, they show up as losses. Unfortunately. I don't know where they go either. Or they just retreat over here, I think, actually. Oh, yeah. Yep. It says it right here. So, the scripting they've done with this mod is insanity. It's so good. It's absolutely just... beautiful how they've... managed to script all this nonsense. It's this old game. This extremely old game. I think we got some factories built up now so we can build some more vehicles. Unit in production. Build up some speeders over here. I just feel like we're in a better position than the New Republic is, honestly. It's a hangar type structure. What is this? A massive supply. The Empire and the Half Fleet to respond to threats. Okay, that's cool. New Republic's actually doing good. Yeah, New Republic's doing good. They're teaching me some things right now. Okay, so now I want to find out what's happening with this little planet right here. Gonna build up a few more supply stations, which is what these are. We might want to prep our defenses over here, because I don't think we're gonna be pushing them in time soon. Actually, leave these tanks on the ground.
Construction complete.
What do we got right here? These guys. I want to get to. I need to take Bobrini before the Empire can properly respond. Lots of stuff is happening.
D2B over.
I think I'm gonna move this fleet up.
At once.
So much happening, man. The feed is a little distracting, though, I will say. Hypervelocity gun has been killed. Interesting. Oh, Veers is dead. I can't stop reading the feed! The feed is so entertaining to read right now. I'm gonna be sad when it says, like, Luke Skywalker has been killed. That's gonna be depressing. It's gonna be more depressing than the actual death in the Last Jedi.
Over.
That movie sucked.
Construction complete.
Let's see. Alright, we're gonna move these guys over here. Oh, we have probe droids. I didn't even see that. Okay. I was wondering about that.
Constructing unit.
We also got a lot of money. We're going to build one of these, though. These gigantic, massive stations.
Construction complete.
I like Empire War Re. Our money isn't just, like, depreciated. Or is it Re, I'm thinking of? Might not be Re. Unlike some other mods, our money isn't just, like, depreciated over time. Like, if you, what you pay for it is just what it is. Back here is confusing. What do we got here? What, is just like a rebel faction or something? Okay. Yeah, it's like a little rebel faction. We'll get some ships to deal with that. Not gonna have this droney. A couple of the mods stop moving. I think there's just too much happening right now, honestly. I might not have all my settings properly set up, settings to do everything. But it's so weird, it's freaking out like this. Okay. We're sending our forces over there. But we're gonna go ahead and drop our troops on. Or they'll just get there before I can literally move my mouse any further. Okay.
We've located the enemy!
We should have a one-on-one ass droney battle.
Yes, sir.
Oh, there are four of them. We are not going to have a one-on-one ass droney battle. That's a cool ship.
Setting course.
We might need more ships. Look at this thing.
Ready to receive orders. Mega Mazer's primed.
Alright, maybe a long-range battleship was not the ideal thing to bring in against, like, an army of corvettes. Maybe? I'm trying to get an attractor beam, though. Did we take out one of them already? Yeah, they just kind of go poof.
Ready to receive orders.
Actually, no. Screw that. Shoot that one. Something about the art style about this, I feel like it's probably going to be updated to more... I don't know if this is what they're going for the modernized look. Okay. Either way, I think it looks pretty dope.
We'll get there. Taking fire.
Oh, the other one just retreated. They're all just retreating.
The enemy has
They're not going to have anywhere to go. That was literally their only planet. So... Rip to those four ass dronies. Alright, in the meantime, we'll go ahead and conquer Bill Beringe.
Invasion commencing.
We've got AT-AT here. We've got aircraft and Star Destroyers and I'm going to assume orbital bombers. But capturing Bill Beringe is our first step in doing many of things right now.
Reporting.
Wow, this is a different map from what I remember. Holy smokes. This game is being so weird right now. Oops. Looks like I have some of our old saves from before. Not sure what the issue could be. Well, I'll have to figure it out later. Hopefully it won't be too much of a problem throughout the rest of this video. But it's been a while since I played Empire War. Let's see what we got here. Are these updated troop models? Kind of looks like it. They're also a lot smaller. Alright, anyway.
Choose your reinforcements.
Alright, so we've got to go that way? On this rock? Let's see.
Course plotted.
Wait, what are these? This one rapid fire takes to deal with some other like, Maya threats. Alright, we just dropped in a unit for free.
Course plotted.
Now we're not gonna drop down that.
Maximum unit capacity. Production halted.
All weapons loaded. T4P mobile. Moving into position.
Okay. Get you in position.
T4P. Awaiting order.
Standing by. Give me
the choice. Three. Commander, take
brigade here. Underway. Almost there.
Ready.
Get some troops stationed over at these points. Moving out. These things move quickly, holy smokes.
We secured a build pad. Sensor node constructing.
Yes, let's see, what do we got here? Flame turret.
There they are. Sensor node constructing. Construction complete.
Entering battlefield. Roger.
Roger.
Oh shit, okay. Let's see, where's our tank at?
Unit.
I'm in another one, please, right now. This is good gameplay, I promise.
Reporting in.
Alright, we're gonna get you. Actually, no, we're just gonna keep moving you up. You guys got this.
Reporting.
I mean, the AT-AT also turned around, too, so. You guys need to stay in its line of sight. What are you doing? Go.
Ready for orders. Get there. Right away.
I do like this approach to a more, like, it's just tanky. I just like this. It's better than just a thousand different versions of the AT-AT over and over. Yeah, this guy's done for. I don't understand why I'm getting these little frame drops like this. These little freezes, rather. Okay.
Alright,
what we're gonna do is send our speeders up ahead and try to do some scouting.
Yes, Commander.
In the meantime, wait, where am I? I've got my map positioning just a tiny bit off.
Squad, move out.
I think they can make it up this hill.
T4B ready. Form up.
Okay, there's the hypervelocity gun that almost ruined our day earlier. There's a little transport. Let's see. Oh wow, that's actually really neat. That's actually really cool. So remember how I talked about me having a god PC? There's something about this mod that's just freaking out right now, and it's not liking it. Dude, look at this. This actually... They've done really nice with the model, like, through the mapping. Let's see. Okay. Not sure what the hell is happening right now, but it's actually starting to really annoy me. None of this should be a problem because I'm, you know. Give me the target. Fall out, troops. I'm running on a really, really, how do I put it, expensive rig? But I'm also just getting a host of, like, weird problems right now. You know, all those technical problems that never occurred before until you actually start doing stuff.
Bombardment available.
Tank brigade here.
Let's see.
Commence assault.
Let's see.
Unit destroyed.
Oh, that's bad. We're gonna call in our air support. Take out this. Oh, that was just like, what is this? That was just a destroyed abandoned vehicle factory at that.
Waiting orders.
Okay, we're gonna get up here.
Right away, sir.
Get our foot soldiers up there.
Ready for attack.
They should be able to do some damage to that. Can they run troopers over? Can they run troopers over? Come on. Or they're just gonna drop dead. Oh, they are kind of running them over. I think their detection box for being run over is a little big.
Copy.
Because that tank wasn't even touching them, and they were just like dropping dead.
I copy.
Put you guys down there. And some vehicle turret up here. When we get an overview of where everything is, we're just gonna go to town and blow everything up.
We secured an abandoned sensor array.
Okay. Make that little job right there just a tiny bit easier.
Bomber standing by.
We're totally gonna miss this one.
Almost there.
Oh, I was wondering why I just got so red all of a sudden. Kinda assume they don't have any form of anti-vehicle stuff up here. Or anti-aircraft rather.
I copy.
Where are our speakers? They're over here. Gonna just go over here and take that out real quick. I see the little missile troops down there, but that's fine.
Turret constructing.
Order acknowledged.
Reporting.
Oh, you can't get this over here. This is completely inaccessible by tanks.
Yes, sir.
Order, sir.
We secured a gun pad.
I wouldn't recommend holding your guns like that, boys.
We secured a gun pad.
Alright, men, take cover!
They even have a new stormtrooper model. Cool.
Right away.
Wouldn't recommend holding their gun like that, though.
Reporting.
That seems extremely far from optimal. But teach their own. Put a little back to tank here. Alright, I'm doing too much micromanaging. Let's just go blow stuff up. We need to get another landing point. Let's just go make it for the launch push.
Yes, sir. En route.
Let's see. Where is it? Power of the weapons. This keyboard's really weird to use when I'm playing RTS. It's more of a shooter keyboard, if you will. Let's go take that out.
Yes, sir.
Let's see.
Moving to that area, sir.
Come on. I'm not getting any younger. Speak it up.
We lost a
weapon float. Roger.
We secured a bill pad. We lost a bill pad. We lost a bill pad.
Reporting in.
We've lost a bill pad.
We secured a landing zone.
Get some guys over here.
Construction complete.
Secure the area.
Over there. Form up. Awaiting orders.
Choose your reinforcements.
What do we got? What is this? Separate assistance against multiple targets. Oh, that's the same. Okay. Calling the flame tank.
Or
the rapid fire tank. Oh, we
don't
need that. We'll call them both flame tanks. They say we're an assault tank, not a boat. That's funny.
Turret constructing. Turret
constructing. Yeah, we've effectively established dominance on this planet thus far. I think it'll blow up. Or we're just freezing. Yeah, these freezers are going to be extremely annoying if we're going to do a playthrough of this. I just forgot what it's called, but no big deal. I've got anti-aircraft stuff over here, so we're just gonna wait till we can hit them with a... probably a bombing run, because those turrets cannot shoot fast enough to shoot bombers down in most cases. Let's see. Okay. Alright, we've got a lot of tanks to work with now, so we'll just move our troops up here. Let's just go secure this landing zone. And we've got a bombing run, pretty much. Let's see. Just a repair facility there. We're honestly just going to win this. We're just going to bomb them out. Your bomb shelter can't save you from this. Yeah. And we'll just send our starfighters over here. This is some very odd terrain. I don't know. Actually, you know what? No, we'll just hit him with the biggest bombardment ever. Okay, so they can go around this and through all these little craters and stuff. He's just gonna keep driving into it. Wow, that is some armor. Imagine having armor just that strong. You can survive an orbital bombardment. That's insane. Actually, what we're going to do is pull you guys back. Or they can just go blow my tank up.
Give me a target.
Yeah, they're not doing anything. Let's get you out of there. Let's get you out of there before you lose more of them. There we go. We got a lot of little turret, like just turret pockets everywhere. Okay.
Roger that. Getting out. Weapons online.
They're probably gonna start retreating. Maybe not. Oh, what else do they have? Oh, these guys right here. Okay, there we go. Winning this battle will give me an immediate income of zero. Okay, well, we gained absolutely nothing in terms of money value out of that, except a strategic place in the galaxy, I guess. Alright, well, we're going to do a scout out of the planet right quick, and then we're going to stop here, because I don't want to drag this on any further with these weird little instances of stuttering that I'm encountering. Actually, they don't have much. They do not have much out there. We're going to start the construction on our big little citadel right here. And yeah, we can actually just start construction on... Wow, we're literally right next door to Coruscant, pretty much. Borlias and the Coruscant, that's insane. The New Republic is so jelly of me right now. Oh, man. We're so close to it. I don't know how they're going to fare. Because the thing is, New Republic worlds are just... Well, she doesn't really count, I guess. Neither does Nahada. So maybe if you wanted to go to Glom... and then San Raf 6, you could. But these guys have so many big ass ships. It's hard to fight these Outer Rim battles. I remember the fleets out here starting off with more ships and being a little bit more tolerable. From what it feels like, we have less ships than they did at the Battle of Endor right now. I don't know. I feel like we need a few more. I don't know. It's New Republic. We're not even playing as New Republic, though. Let me stop talking about them for a hot second. I kind of don't know what the direction I want to go with these guys right now, because they have a lot already. They've got so much advantage currently, like being in a nice little isolated corner, significantly less dangerous planets surrounding them. Like, the rest of the galaxy literally has to deal with one another. The Empire of the Hand is just kind of like in a spot where we can just push out constantly. We don't really have to worry about, you know, people just pushing into our territory because they can't reach us. So, I don't know, guys. I'm going to figure out the weird stuttering issue. Maybe it's just something I haven't set up yet when I reinstalled this game into my new PC. Maybe something I missed. Did some testing earlier. Everything was fine. So, not sure what the issue could be, but we'll find out in the next episode. Thank you all so much for watching. May the Force be with you all. Peace.